Synapse Engineering, I'm Alan. Today we're looking at sign bars and we're making a sign bar that fits the compound slide. Now before you start making a sign bar for the compound slide, you need to make sure that your slide has a machined face that the sign bar will set to. The sign bar also has magnets inside that will hold it to the top of the compound slide and make it easier to set. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Today we're looking at sign bars. That's a sign bar I made when I was apprentice, and this is another type of sign bar, similar idea, but on this one you have two radiuses on there. Make an angle like that using slip gauges under the top so you can put your work on the top and shake it. This one's designed to hold it up like that with slip gauges under there to the right height, giving you the angle you need, and you put your work on the top. It can have a face on the bottom that you can screw on so you can put your work on the end. You can also get vices for milling machines that have a built-in sign bar. And on a grinding machine, you can get magnetic tables that have a sign bar built into them. I'm using a scrap of aluminium that I had in the workshop. Well, the first thing I want to do is get this face roughly level. Doesn't need to be that accurate, really. So 2.5 there. I'm using WD-40 to stop the aluminium sticking to the tool. That's nice. Take that out. So I'll file the edges off, and that's the first datum face. I'll just set the face square by eye. It's not important. It's not going to be used for measuring, so it's just to get a nice finish on the face. So what I've done now is just marked it up with some blue, marking out blue, and I've scribed the line down the centre. So all I will do on this is just get a better finish than a saw cut on it, take a few thou off that side, a few thou off that side, leave that rad on, then that's ready for the drilling operation. That's just a rough shape. There's nothing special about the shape. It's just big enough to fit on my compound slide. So now we'll see where we can put the magnets on this. It's important that you check that your vice jaw is parallel to the table. When I clocked up the jaw, I used a parallel strip on the side because this extends the jaw so you can get a longer run on your dial indicator. Let's put that there, hold it down, lock it up. So I know that this back face, which is my datum face,
is parallel.
And what I want to do is drill two holes along that line for the sign bar datums,
and then drill another four holes in here to hold the magnets.
I've got a spot drill here. I've moved in from the edge, and I've moved in from this edge. I've measured the distance I want. This will make a 75 millimeter sign bar.
Or you could make it 3 inches.
I'm just going to drill through with this spot drill, and then move down 75 mil and drill through again. reading down 75 millimetres.
And then drill out at 7 millimetres.
I want to ream this now at 8 millimetres. So I'll slow the speed down. The same again on the other hole.
I've changed the drill to another spot drill and I want to drill four holes on the base for the magnets.
Change your tool, re-zero. The depth. Move it back to the centre.
And that will give me a flat bottom hole.
Now change the tool for a
12 millimetre end mill and reset the depth.
And we can go down 8.5 mm.
Now this larger end mill doesn't cut flat across the whole face. That's why I use the smaller one to start. And repeat that for all the holes that hold the magnets.
Now that's the aluminium finish with. On this side I have two holes for the sign bar locations and four holes for magnets. The next job is on the lathe. The next job is to turn the aluminium bungs, which will go in these holes, and hold the magnets in position. So we need to turn this diameter of aluminium down to fit this 12 mil hole. And then in the end, put a recess to hold the magnets, which is 5 mil deep, 10 mil diameter. And then part it off. That's just starting to go in on that one. So next job is to drill a hole 10 mil diameter
by 5 mil deep
with a flat bottom. So I'll centre drill that first.
Five millimetre deep. And now drilling 7 mm diameter by 5 mm deep. Now change for a 10 mm end mill.
Just touch it on the end
zero my tailstock depth indicator and go in 5 millimeters. Okay, I'm ready to part off, so I've just touched my parting off tool on the end, zeroed my readout, so move in 8.2 plus the width of the tool, which is 2.3 millimeters. Lock the saddle and I'll have to part that off there. Some WD-40, as the aluminium tends to stick to the parting off tool. So that just fits in there. I'm not going to push it in yet because all I need to do is face this off.
And now I have to make another three.
This is the last one. Not tighten it very tight because it's thin. It's only a 2 millimeter wall.
And remove the sharp edge. Well, that's the four. I've pressed one in. I'll put the magnets inside and press those in.
There's the magnet inside. I'll press it back in with the tailstock. Move on to the next one. Another one done. This is the finished part. This side you can't see much. On this side, four magnets hidden under this and the two centres.
And that fits on the top of the compound slide.
The magnets hold it on. And then, depending on your angle, you put gauge blocks under either this end or under this end, depending on which way you want to go. I could make that bigger, but that was the only piece of aluminium I had. It could go anywhere on there.
As long as you have a machined edge on your compound slide.
With sine bars, you can go up to probably nearly 45. Once you go over 45, it starts losing its
accuracy. If you want to set the compound slide to 10 degrees,
move it around to 10. Then what you need to do is find the sine for 10 degrees. So if you
find sine on your calculator.
So I want 10 degrees and that's a sine. That gives me 0.1736. We'll multiply it by 75, which is the distance between the centres on the sine bar, which is 13 millimetres.
So you put 13 millimetres under the end of the sine bar, or if you want it in inches, you just multiply that
by
25.4.
That gives me 0.5127. So if I put 0.5127 in slip gauges on the face.
The magnet should hold the plate down onto the compound slide.
Then I run the dial indicator along this, and when that is zero, you would have set it to 10 degrees. Set your dial indicator to zero. And then get your sine bar reading zero to zero, which is that.
Just check that it wasn't stuck.
And if I double check, look at my angle. It looks like 10, but now I know it's dead on 10 degrees. You can see the pressure of the magnets just hold your slip gauges, so you can concentrate on getting a zero on your dial indicator just by moving the compound slide. Now that means that if you're doing a job and you need to have an exact angle, you can set it up easy. If you want to machine a Morse taper, you can set the angle and you can repeatedly set it to the correct angle. All you need to know is the distance between the centres of your sine bar, and you can calculate
the size.
If you're a bit worried or you don't have a calculator with sine on, you can go on the internet and just put sine bar calculations and a calculator will appear. You could put it in metric, any size of sine bar, and it will give you the length you need in slip gauges.
Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful, hope it's interesting, and we'll see you next time on E-Notch Engineering.